Hi, this is Shreng Siddharth and welcome to another interesting video on Android. Now in this one single video, you are going to master everything you need to know about spannable strings in Android, along with the complete source code. So what you will cover in this video? Suppose we have a text view. We all can style a text view directly from XML layout, right? But if you want to style a small part of your text, like this word is colored here, then we need to use the concept of spannable string. So we are basically styling a particular span of text, not throughout the text. Fine. Next, we can partly change the background color of the text, like you can see here. We can make a word bold and also partly change the font size as well. We can underline something or even we can italicize something as well. We can even make a text clickable, on click of which we can perform some action as well, like opening a web page or showing a toast. So it could be anything. So let's get started. So here within my layout, I have added three text views. You can get this layout from the gist files. The link is in the description. So just download the file and get started. And on the right is my emulator, which is showing the current application status. And within my main activity, I have added some basic code. And within these functions, which are defined here, I will style my three text views, which you can find it on the right. Fine. So let us start with the first text view. So to implement a spannable string, our first step will be to create a spannable string object. Then I want the text to be of red color. So I will create a foreground color span object with color red. Now I want this high to be red. So within this string, we have h at 0th position and I at 1st position, just like an array of characters, right? So I will use spannable string dot set span method, pass foreground color object, then define start and end characters from where to where you want to apply the style, and then define the flag which will determine on which part you want to apply the effect. Well, this span inclusive exclusive means that include this starting character, which is h in our case, and exclude this second character, which is space in our case. So 0 is h, I is 1, then second position is taken by the space. So the space will be excluded. So from 0 up to 2, it will be colored as red. Fine. Now, apart from this flag, we also have other four variants as well, such as span inclusive exclusive, inclusive inclusive, then other permutation and combination as well. So accordingly, you can use it. But right now I will use span inclusive exclusive. Great. Then finally, let's apply this spannable string to our text view 1. Now, if you're not able to get this text view 1, which is the ID of the text view present in our layout, then go to your Gradle file and please make sure to add this Kotlin AnRoute extensions. And then sync your project. So that is it, we are now done. Let us run the application and let's see what we get. So here we go, this high got colored to red. Great, isn't it? Now I want my name Shreng Siddharth to be background colored as green. So how to do it on the same text? So for that, all you have to do is create a background color span object with some color. And then set the span. So this third position is the position of S, and this 21 is the position of dot. So it will exclude the dot and set the span till here. Fine, run the application. Well, it looks ugly, but for now it's great. So in this way, using the same spannable string, you can apply multiple styles, like foreground color and background color. And accordingly, you can add more styles to it. Now, The spannable string object is actually immutable in nature. That is, once you define this object with a text, you cannot change it. So suppose if we want to append some text to the right of our current text, then what we can do is we can just convert it to spannable string builder. And accordingly, let's update the variable name everywhere. So this spannable string builder is actually mutable in nature. That is, you can change it anytime. So I will use spannable string builder dot append function and add the text as per my requirement, such as welcome. Run the app. So there it is. We got text appended at the end. Now moving on, let us do some operation on our second text view. For that, we have this text to span function. Here I will create a spannable string object with some text. And suppose I want to make this font size of this how as double of what it was originally. So for that I will use relative size span object and pass 2f as parameter. Now this will make your font as double of its original size. If you make it 5, then your font size will become 5 times of its original. So let's make it 2. And then set it to our spannable string object. And make sure you pass the correct start and end points. Great. And finally set the text of our text view 2 as spannable string. Perfect. Run the application. So here we go, we got text size as double of its original. How cool is that? Now suppose I want to make the same text as bold. So how to do that? Again, I will create a style span object and pass constant as typeface.bold. Well, you can select your own typeface as well, such as bold italic, italic, normal, and so on. I will use bold only. And then set it to our spannable string object. So I will just copy this statement, paste it here, and change it to style span. Run the application. There we go. How has now become bold? Now suppose I want to make this U as underline. So how to do that? Well, again, you have to create an underline span object. And then accordingly set the span with appropriate start and end points. Run the application. So here it is, you got underlined. Perfect. So hi Shrank Siddharth, welcome. How are you? So on the third text view, let us do something creative so that it supersedes the previous two text views. So in our third text view or third function, let us try to add some code and make it clickable. Like this text is going to speak itself, how are you? So here I will create a spannable string object, which we'll say click to know. And this time we need to code a little bit. We need to create an anonymous inner class object that will implement the abstract class of clickable span. And this clickable span is an abstract class which contains an abstract methods, which is onClick. So let's override that method. And within this method, I will display a toast message. Well, of course, you can get the code of opening a web page or something, or any other action that you want to perform on click of this text. Up to you. And finally, we are going to set the spannable string to the text view. But here, you need to add an additional statement. So, you need to set the movement method on your text view to this link movement method instance. Well, this will make your click process functional. Let's run the application. Click on this text view. And I think I forgot to set the span. So let's do that as well. Pass clickable span. This time I want to set the span to the entire text. So I will use 0 to 13. Great. Let's run it now. Click on this text. There we go. I am great. I got a toast message. Click again. Perfect. Well, right now our text has got some default color or the application color. So let's make it blue in color so that it will look like a clickable link. And also, suppose I want to remove this underline from here. Then let's see how to do that. So for that, within your clickable span implementation, all you have to do is override update draw state method. And within this, you need to make use of this DS variable, such as ds.changeTheColor. And then also change the underline to, let's say, false. I will use ds.isUnderlineText, the property equal to false. Run it. There we go. We got a blue text without any underline. Click it. It is working perfectly fine. Nice and simple. So I think we now know everything you need to know about the spannable string in Android. You can find the entire source code link in the description. This is Shrink Siddharth signing off, and thanks for watching. See you next time.